After Bortsov's performance in the 1972 Games, many people believed that in Montreal he would become the first man to retain the Olympic 100 meters title. The people of Trinidad never shared that belief. They'd seen a new and confident challenge being prepared. In the mind of Hazley Crawford, Bortsov was more than an opponent, he was a target. Heavily influenced by the Black Power movement of the late 60s, Crawford resented Bortsov being portrayed as the great white hope. That bitterness grew after injury destroyed his chances of challenging Bortsov in the 1972 Olympics. For the young man from Trinidad, it was a sickening blow. But he knew how to ride it. After all, his entire life had been a process of survival against the odds. One of 11 children, Hazley was a single-minded boy. When he discovered his athletic talent, he worked it for all he was worth. His first reward was a bronze medal in the 1970 Commonwealth Games. But after taking up a scholarship from East Michigan University, he badly injured his back in a road accident and was forced out of competition for 18 months. He recovered early in Olympic year and put together a string of fine performances until his thigh injury betrayed him in the Munich Games.
I had it in me for 4 years. So what I did, I corrected all my mistakes of 72, and I came prepared for 76.
Yet Crawford entered those 76 Olympics beset by personal problems. In the year before the Games, he'd married and separated. His scholarship had ended, and he'd taken a job in Detroit, designing gears for racing cars. As his workload increased, his training suffered. Yet perversely, he was running better than ever. He was impatient for the Olympics to arrive. For its part, Montreal would have been prepared to wait forever. Boycotted by 22 African nations, plagued by corruption and conducted in a cloud of financial chaos, the Games of Montreal will stand as the ultimate example of Olympic mismanagement.
1976, célébrant la 21e Olympiade de l'ère moderne.
And yet, as so often, the Games were made memorable by the athletes. Montreal gave us Lassie Viren, retaining both his 5,000 and 10,000 meters titles. It gave us Alberto Huantarena, taking gold medals at both 400 and 800 meters. And it gave us Hazley Crawford, carrying the flag of Trinidad and preparing to make his own dramatic statement. His main rivals were now assembling their own challenges. There was Bortsov, of course, almost back to his best after injury problems. Crawford's confidence grew when he beat him in the heats. There was Jamaica's Don Quarry, whose placid temperament concealed blazing ability. Crawford took care of him in the semi-final. So with the American Steve Williams absent through injury, Crawford knew this was his chance to prove himself the fastest man on earth. But he had to control his nerves. And on the night before the final, that task was almost impossible.
I can recall reading a Bible. I can recall changing my outfit about 6 or 7 times. I can recall because of my behavior, my teammates, they couldn't sleep. They tied me at one point to the bed.
Before the race, still bubbling with nervous energy, he entered the dressing room singing at the top of his voice.
Corey turned to me and said, "You're crazy." And I said to him, I said, "You think I'm crazy? I see you, see you're crazy, I'm gonna go out there with you." I saw Harvey Glantz and Johnny Jones. They were looking at television. And I knew I hadn't beaten, because here it is, you have an Olympic final and you're sitting down looking at television. I knew they were scared. They were young, they were scared. And I went to them and said, "I'll kick you two black asses." And I mean, that just shattered them. One person I did not move was Vali Bortsov. He kept looking at me. He kept kicking his feet and making a hissing sound of, but at no time at all, he kept his eyes off me. And I knew that I had to beat him.
Won 4 years ago by Valery Borzov, who is attempting to become the first man to ever successfully defend a sprint championship. There's Paisley Crawford of Trinidad, and that's his habit to turn his back to the finish line. In lane three, the defender from 72, Valery Borzov. Corey in four, Glantz in lane five. Borzov with the ability to accelerate, with the ability to shift gears after moving about 50 meters down the track. Let's listen to the starter's instructions.
Set.
Glantz away very quickly. Borzov trying. trying to move up. Quarry's going with him. On the inside is Hazley Crawford. Crawford's going to be there. He's got the
yes.
Quarry's got the silver, and Borzov got the bronze. Hazley Crawford of Trinidad, who fell and was injured in 1972 during a victory lap of the track. He has won the gold medal with a time of 10.05 seconds.
When the gun went off, Harvey Glanz, he reacted first, then Borzov. I said to myself, oh, Jesus Christ, not again, because, you know, he had beat me in 72. And then three strides, I had passed him.
Quarry, three lanes away, was also worrying about Borzov.
At around 60, I saw Borzov in front. Right away, I said, oh, no, he's not going to win again. That just came across just automatically. I took off, I caught him, and in going by him, I figured I've got it won. Then I saw Hazley. Hazley won that 100 because he came there to run. He didn't care about anyone else. He got up, he took off, and he held it over the last 20 meters.
Crawford first in 10.06 seconds. Quarry second in 10.08. Borzov third in 10.14. For the first time in 48 years, there were no Americans on an Olympic 100 meters rostrum. Crawford went home to celebrations which lasted for weeks. They gave him the nation's highest civic decoration. They put his face on postage stamps. They even named a jet plane after him. He competed in two more Olympics, but ran without the same hunger. And finally, he retired from the track to take on the job as director of sport in Trinidad. He never disguised the brash competitive streak in his nature, but there is a more reflective side to that complex personality.
I do say to myself, what's the purpose of winning this gold medal? Because basically I'm a private person. And there are times that people come and they say nasty things to me. I feel resentful and I feel it's unnecessary. People still tend to look at the Caribbean countries as nothing. And that's why it was a pleasure to be the world